Okay, this is HAARP, High Frequency Vandalism in the Sky. This is a review of Angels Don't Play This HAARP by Dr. Nick Begich and Jeannie Manning. This is from 1996. So yes, this is old, but it's got some very interesting issues in here. HAARP will zap the upper atmosphere with a focused and steerable electromagnetic beam. It is an advanced model of an ionospheric heater. The ionosphere is the electrically charged sphere surrounding Earth's upper atmosphere. It ranges between about 40 to 600 miles above Earth's surface. Put simply, the apparatus for HAARP is a reversal of a radio telescope. Antennas send out signals instead of receiving. Okay, this is also kind of interesting because I know some people have tried to debunk Dutch Sense's HAARP rings and going in and showing that they're, you know, that there's nothing there but radnet or whatever. Well, here it is. HAARP is a reversal of a radio telescope. Antennas send out signals instead of receiving. HAARP is the test run for a superpowerful radio wave beaming technology that lifts areas of the ionosphere by focusing a beam and heating those areas. Electromagnetic waves then bounce back onto Earth and penetrate everything, living and dead. HAARP publicity gives the impression that the high-frequency active auroral research project is mainly an academic project. We know otherwise. They're trying to exploit the ionosphere. Okay, so the military says HAARP system could give the military a tool to replace the electromagnetic pulse effect of atmospheric thermonuclear devices. Still considered a viable option. Replace the huge extremely low frequency or ELF submarine communication system operating in Michigan and Wisconsin with a new and more compact technology. It could be used to replace the over the horizon radar system with more flexible and accurate systems. It could provide a way to wipe out communications over an extremely large area while keeping the military's own communication systems working. It could provide a wide area earth penetrating tomography, which if combined with the computing abilities of EMAS and Cray computers, this would make it possible to verify many parts of nuclear non-proliferation and peace agreements. It could also be a tool for geophysical probing to find oil, gas, and mineral deposits over a large area, and it could be used to detect incoming low-level planes and cruise missiles, making other technologies absolutely obsolete. Okay, goes into a little bit of HAARP history here. I'm not going to go into that because I've already pounded a lot of information out in videos regarding Bernard Eastlund and, you know, how he took some of Nikola Tesla's early work and ramped it up, sold out, and sold it over to ARCO. Weather modification is possible, for example, altering upper atmosphere wind patterns by constructing one or more plumes of atmospheric particles, which will act as a lens or focusing device. Mental manipulation. This is something that I have not really delved into yet. Maybe because I'm being manipulated. Okay, gotta laugh. Related research uncovered some bizarre schemes. Air Force documents revealed that a system had been developed for manipulating and disrupting human mental processes through pulsed radio frequency radiation, over large geographical areas. The most telling material about this technology came from writings from Mr. Brzezinski, former National Security Advisor to President Carter. That's way back. They wrote about the use of power beaming transmitters for geophysical and environmental warfare. These effects might be caused, and the negative effects on human health and thinking. The mental disruption possibilities are the most disturbing. More than 40 pages of the book, with dozens of footnotes, chronicle the work of Harvard professors, military planners, and scientists as they plan and test this use of the electromagnetic technology. For example, one of the papers describing this use was from the International Red Cross in Geneva. It even gave the frequency ranges where these effects could occur, the same ranges which HAARP is capable of broadcasting. This following statement was made more than 25 years ago. Political strategists are tempted to exploit research on the brain and human behavior. Problems of warfare, says accurately timed, artificially excited electronic strokes could lead to a pattern of oscillations that produce relatively high power levels over certain regions of the Earth. In this way, one could develop a system that would seriously impair the brain performance of very large populations in selected regions over an extended period of time. And then one of the other things, well, yesterday's physicist predicted today's advances. Are HAARP program managers delivering on the vision? Is HAARP another step in a journey from which we cannot turn back? Personally, I say yes. I say we've already gone over the edge with this. And what is really sad to me is that that it doesn't seem to really matter to anybody, because they're definitely not stopping. You know, the artificial electromagnetic fields are wide ranging and can be used in many military or quasi-military situations. I mean, you know, these applications are pretty much going to the highest bidder. And the HAARP facilities are all over the planet. They might not look like the HAARP that's in Alaska. They could look like just a radnet station. It could look like just a radar system. So it's, you know, here's one of the other issues, and I had read this before. HAARP high frequency emissions can couple with the long wave, low frequency, or ELF pulses the Earth grid uses to distribute information as vibrations to synchronize dances of life in the biosphere. The geomagnetic action, Earth's information bloodstream, and says it is like coupling, it's likely that coupling of HAARP high frequency with natural ELF frequency can cause unplanned and unsuspected side effects. This is a dangerous understatement of what HAARP's gigantic gigawatt beam will do. Earth is spinning relative to thin electric shells of multi-layer membrane of ionospheres that absorb the Earth's shield from intense solar radiation. So when they start creating these shields, and they're slicing through the ionosphere. They're literally like cutting into it, and that won't come back. So they're saying in here that that is why there really is atmospheric changes going on. And that is something that I also need to do a little bit more research on to find out exactly how extensive it can be when they place their little shell around or slice in and put these beams around the earth that could mess up the entire world's weather patterns. Okay, so anyway, I'll put now a little bit more here. I'm having fun going in on this research stuff. God bless.